Gon had long felt that it was time for him to find a wife, for all the ladies in the neighborhood paid him so much attention that it made him quite shy. But he was not easy to please and did not care about any of them. Now, before he had time to think, Cupid had entangled him in his net, and he was filled with love towards Coma. She fully returned his passion, but like a woman, she saw the difficulties in the way and consulted sadly with Gon as to the means of overcoming them. Gon entreated his master to set matters right by buying Coma, but her mistress would not part from her. Then the music master was asked to sell Gon to the lady, but he declined to listen to any such suggestion, so everything remained as before. At length, the love of the couple grew to such a pitch that they determined to please themselves and to seek their fortunes together. So one moonlight night, they stole away and ventured out into an unknown world. All day long, they marched bravely on through the sunshine till they had left their homes far behind them, and towards evening, they found themselves in a large park. The wanderers by this time were very hot and tired, and the grass looked very soft and inviting, and the trees cast cool, deep shadows when suddenly an ogre appeared in this paradise, in the shape of a big, big dog. He came springing towards them, showing all his teeth, and Coma shrieked and rushed up a cherry tree. Gon, however, stood his ground boldly and prepared to give battle, for he felt that Coma's eyes were upon him and that he must not run away. But alas, his courage would have availed him nothing had his enemy once touched him, for he was large and powerful and very fierce.